first honorable prime minister Jawaharlal Nehru had said when we first got independence, a new star rises, the star of freedom in the east. A new hope comes into being, a vision long cherished materializes. May the star never set and the hope never betrayed. Looking back, we realize how far our country has progressed in the past 75 years. Post-independence, not many people gave India a chance to remain as one single nation, and the partition of the nation was only a grim reminder in this regard. But India as a nation has stood the test of time, and today is the world's largest democracy with over 600 million people exercising the right to vote in the last Lok Sabha elections. Right after independence, we were facing many challenges: lack of food security, poor literacy, lack of capital to develop industries, the threat to war, to name a few. With import substitution as a policy, we embarked on building a self-reliant India. Dams became the modern temples, and technical institutions such as IITs were set up to harvest human resources. With the relentless efforts of the likes of M.S. Swaminathan and many others, India today not only ensured its food security, but also runs the world's largest midday meal program. India has also made significant progress in terms of its literacy rate, from being just 18.3% during the 1950s to 52% during the 1990s to 73% in 2011. India was not bogged down by its internal challenges to stand for what is right. At a time when it would have been convenient to take the side of one of the two dominant powers, India played a key role in the formation of the non-aligned movement. With the liberalization of the economy in the 1990s, the private sector started playing a more proactive role, with India emerging as one of the fastest growing large economies in the world. In the area of space, from not having a space mission to launching a successful mission to Mars in the first attempt, and one of the first countries to find water on the moon. India is considered as a pharmacy of the world, being the world's largest vaccine manufacturer, and its role in containing the current global pandemic is appreciated by world leaders. With India approaching its 75th independence anniversary, our Honorable Prime Minister inaugurated the 75 weeks to 75th Independence Day celebrations with the inauguration of Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav. The celebration started with the commemoration ceremony of the Dandi March, which was taken up by Mahatma Gandhi as a civil disobedience movement to protest against the unjust monopoly of the British Raj regarding the manufacturing of salt. As his Honorable Prime Minister cited in his speech, that for Indians, salt represents honesty, trust, loyalty, labor, equality and self-reliance. Amrit Mahotsav means an elixir of energy of independence. It means elixir of inspirations of the warriors of the freedom struggle, elixir of new ideas and pledges, and the nectar of Atmanirbharta. The whole idea behind the 75-week-long celebrations is to create a vision for India at 2047, when India will be celebrating its 100 years of independence. While India has surely come a long way in its journey, there are still many pressing challenges. India is still ranked 131 in the UNDP's Human Development Index. It is still home to the largest number of malnourished children in the world. The focus has now shifted from food security to nutritional security. While India has achieved near universal enrollment at the primary level, the learning outcomes are not very encouraging, as captured by the Annual Status on Education report. Indian economy did not develop the secondary sector to the desirable extent, which could have absorbed excess labor from the agricultural sector. With estimates ranging from 5 to 12 million people joining Indian job markets annually, it is a challenge for India to convert this opportunity of having a young population into a demographic dividend. Thus, there is a need to give India a boost to the manufacturing sector through Atmanirbhar Bharat, and also emerge as a startup hub of the world. With advancements in technology such as the Internet of Things, blockchain, 5G, India should match up to other advanced economies so as to avoid the middle income trap. We also have to strive to reduce the wealth inequalities by providing equal opportunities as provided in our constitution. Global warming is a disaster that can lead to the submergence of low-lying coastal areas and increase the frequency of disasters such as droughts and tropical cyclones. It is expected to reduce agricultural productivity and impact food security, as mentioned in the Economic Survey of 2019 to 20. While India has taken a proactive role with its targets pledged for the Paris Climate Deal and being at the forefront of the International Solar Alliance, it should take the leadership role of leading the world towards a more sustainable future. With inspiration from the freedom struggle, India can surely overcome the challenges and take its rightful place in the global community of nations. Lastly, I would like to thank Vani, the Literary and the Public Speaking Club of IIM Amritsar for giving me this opportunity, and the 50mm Club, the Photography Club of IIM Amritsar, for covering this shoot. Thank you.